Back in the book segment tonight, did you see that? As we mentioned with Dick Morris, President Obama believes that raising taxes on the wealthy is actually going to help the economy, and he's not alone.
There's no real history illustrating that these tax cuts for the rich result in jobs. It's extending unemployment benefits that creates economic activity that creates jobs, not giving a millionaire an extra $10,000 or $20,000 or $30,000 in tax cuts that they likely won't spend because they're already buying what they're going to buy anyway.
Yes, Senator Sherrod Brown, very liberal guy, saying that unemployment benefits stir the economy. You're not analyzed that incredible soundbite, Juliet Hoodie. You know, I don't know if Senator Brown is an economist or not, but I really haven't heard that very often.
I am certainly not an economist either.
No.
But I have done my research, William, and I will tell you this, that I have basically, when it comes to experts in macroeconomics, definitively say the tax cuts, the Bush tax cuts, were effective. Conversely, experts in macroeconomics definitively say that they were not effective. So I think what it comes down to is the average non-expert in economics can basically glean from all this that it depends on sort of how you look at things.
All right, what do you want to believe? But isn't there a pattern of information when Ronald Reagan cut taxes, the economy started to boom a little bit? When Bush, after 9/11 attack, cut taxes, the economy started to go up. When JFK cut taxes, the economy started to go up. Isn't that a matter of record?
Yes, it is. But I mean, I think one of the things that he was saying was that
Sherrod Brown
was saying was that these tax cuts were not effective. I mean,
But that's not true.
There was job growth.
Yeah.
It wasn't as large as it.
Well, we came out of all three economic malaise by three different presidents, two Republicans and one Democrat, cutting taxes. And he says there's no evidence of that. And I'm going, I think there is.
Well, there is.
Okay.
But that's why we're here
to tell people that Sherrod Brown doesn't know what he's talking about.
But he's also, but you know, there are also so many other things to factor in. You know,
you can equivocate all day long, and that's
but
that's not what we do here. All right. Now, chia. Everybody knows chia but me. What is
you don't
chia?
Know what
I kind of know what it is, but you tell
you
me
know what
it
a
is.
Chia pet is.
What is it?
It's the little statue figurine thing that has, you pour water on it and the hair grows out. It's like a plant.
It's a plant.
It's a very strange
and
plant.
People buy
strange
it.
Strange people buy it, yes.
Okay. All
no
right.
offense, I'm just
so
kidding.
So they have a tape. They have a tape on chia. Let's roll it.
To honor three great American presidents with an American icon.
Chia.
A special presidential edition. Washington, our founding father. Lincoln, freedom for all. Obama, hope and prosperity. Plus, the Statue of Liberty with the ever-glowing flame. Seed, water, and watch them grow.
Okay, so this is obviously a satire, right?
No, this is real.
This is real. You buy that?
Yes, people.
There's a kit.
It's called the Proud to Be an American line, and
how much does it cost?
$19.99.
So $20. So you can make
a cool $20, and you get that.
You get some green hair on Washington, Obama, and Lincoln.
Okay, yes, but unfortunately, last year Walgreens pulled the Obama chia.
It's okay to have green hair on Lincoln and Washington, but not on Obama.
Because it doesn't look like an afro, and apparently having a hair that looks like an afro is now racist, according to some.
Why would anyone buy this? Is there a reason?
Well, why did we buy those little trolls, the little strange troll things?
I never bought a strange troll.
I'm sure you never did anything.
I see them every day for free in New York. I don't have to buy them. All right? Well, why would anybody buy this?
Because it's just cute.
It's
just, you put it in your little window sill.
In my little window.
We don't all live in an expansive, massive mansions like you do.
Let me just break this to you, honey.
We can't have
There's no
plants.
Massive mansion in my life, but if I saw the chia in somebody's window, I would keep walking.
That's because you like to marinate in your own misery.
Marinate in my own misery.
That. You don't want to have any fun.
Chia, everybody, $20 if you want to see that happen.
Go get the chia.
If there's one factor viewer who would buy that, please email me, okay, and explain. Huddy, thank you as always.
You're welcome.
We appreciate
my pleasure.
Penn Patriots in a moment.